Mustangs!
I'm Leslie Lugren.
And I'm Stephanie Hillen.
And welcome to our final episode of MBC The 713.
Also known as...
The Leslie and Stephanie Show.
Hey Leslie, have you seen any good movies lately?
Yeah, Griff and Garrett have an awesome trailer to show us.
And then we're waving the green flag over to Hank, Steven, Paul, and Tom, our NASCAR crew. Ladies and gentlemen,
start your engines!
Howdy folks, I'm Hank Lynch.
And I'm Stephen Walker.
And we're here to inform you about the great sport of NASCAR.
Best sport this country's ever seen.
You know, when we start this NASCAR talk, it's hard for me to refrain from quoting one of the best American authors who ever lived. One by the name of Ernest Hemingway.
He's a genius.
He once said that NASCAR, bull riding, and rock climbing are the only real sports. That everything else is just a game.
You know what? That guy's a real smart man.
Very smart man.
Well, with that said, Memorial, let's see what some of our students have to say. Start your engines.
NASCAR's a real tough sport, you know, out there. They've been rolling around there about for centuries now, for more than about a long time.
Started in 1776 when our forefathers came over.
I know that it tests your mind, your brain, and your head.
My dream is just be behind the wheel of a NASCAR car.
Well, you see, the first thing in NASCAR is that you gotta start the engine. You gotta
feel them horsepowers right underneath my feet.
You gotta rev it up, you gotta get it real going, and you gotta see, they come around there to the corner about a shift, huh? And they come around and you gotta
We always drive my house down to the middle of Daytona, and we watch the race. Now Denver's gonna tell you a little about NASCAR himself too.
Well, us buddies, we got a sweet little trailer park, go down to Daytona every year. What I love about Daytona is it's the first race of the year. You got your biggest race starting out the season. You got Dale Earnhardt Jr., you got Jeff Gordon all fighting out there, rubbing paint. You know, rubbing is racing, that's what I always say.
Well, Denver, tell them the story about the saddest day in NASCAR.
One second. Well, it always chokes me up. So I was sitting there, around TV with my little TV dinner, me and Chubbs, watching Talladega. And we saw it was about the end of the race, and we saw Dale Earnhardt get pushing the wall. And I was like, Dale, why aren't you getting out of the car, man? Why aren't you getting out of the car? Met emergency runs around, they're getting him out there, and they don't run him over. So, Dale's dead. The king of NASCAR is gone.
He's dead.
He's gone, man.
He's never
gone. Okay. At least we got Junior, though.
Yeah, we got Junior. So
that's
fine.
I'm Colin Zander. I used to drive car number 36, sponsored by Harris County Bail Bonds. I'm here to talk about the dangers of driving NASCAR. NASCAR ain't no sport for wussies. You see, you're driving around 220 miles an hour. You can't be bumping in under cars. Next thing you know, we're going to be flying air. You got to be aware of all your surroundings. You can't let anything get by you. You know, because next thing you know, you're upside down, your car's on fire, and you're strapped in there. You don't know how to get out. Next thing you know, you're in the hospital with 12 broken bones, and you can't even see out of your left eye. And I ain't good, because then you ain't getting the car for 7 years. I'm afraid I can't even drive, man. I don't even know how no more. I forgot. I got shrapnel in my eye. Freaking shrapnel in my eye, in my eye.
NASCAR, it's a really intense sport. You get 200 miles an hour all around the track, all left turns, four turns per lap.
Who's your favorite driver?
Kyle Busch, because he's the best ever. He wins every race. My favorite race when Kyle Busch won was had to be when he did the Bristol sweep in 08. He won the Truck Series, the Nationwide, and the Sprint Cup Series, and he brought the brooms out during Victory Lane.
Yeah.
NASCAR was first introduced to me probably when I was 4 years old. I'm actually named after Jeff Gordon, so I'm Jeff Gordon Wilhelm, and I used to always watch him when I was a kid. because he was my favorite driver because he had the same name as me.
So I'm going around, I turn, I hit the wall, I go up the wall, I'm going down the wall, right? And he's coming up, turn left, oh, I'm rolling, I keep rolling, it's on fire, right? And I hit the wall, and my car exploded. And I come around that corner, and they go,
well, boys, couldn't have said any better myself.
I couldn't agree more. With that being said, we're going to wave the checkered flag on this segment. From all of us at the sports team, Hank Clinch,
Steven Walker,
behind the scenes, Tom Schatzman and Paul Howie. Until next year, stay classy, Memorial.
And Jake, take it away.
NASCAR.
Yo, it's coming. Yeah, I got him.
Never mind.
Wait a second!
Are you tired of being bullied? Do you want to become stronger? Here's the solution, Red Buffalo.
Oh my god, man, I'm out of here.
Red Buffalo!
Wow, that was a flavorful piece.
Speaking of flavors, Steffi and I have prepared a game for y'all called Name That Food.
Speaking of food, I'm really stressed about after prom.
After we talk about after prom, we're gonna talk about dealing with stress. Is that good?
Yeah.
I'm Kiki Schwartz.
And I'm Kai Jones.
Kai, what's going on?
I don't know, I'm just super stressed right now.
Well, you're in luck, because we're about to see some great ways to deal with stress at Memorial High School.
Really? Let's check it out!
Sarah, don't even get me started on this day. It's been awful.
What's wrong?
I've just been thinking about all my finals that have coming up.
I know exactly what you need.
What?
Some Miley Cyrus.
That dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying. Gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move.
Ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb.
She's Henry Vaughn.
HB_123.
How do you deal with stress?
Well, I'm a senior, so I don't really have any stress.
Well, what about your girlfriend, Catherine Coconut?
Yeah, I guess she gives me a little stress. She's always trying to nag me, but I'm in charge of my relationship, so.
Sounds like you'll have it figured out.
Wow, that was really inspiring. I'm going to go sing to some Miley Cyrus now.
And I really want to go talk to friends.
That's it for today. Back to you, Leslie and Stephanie.